Hi guys, today I want to introduce you to BeliveTV. It's a third-party app that you can use for Facebook Live, but it gives you extra functionality like you can see here on the homepage where you've got three people on screen. You also can do screen sharing. You can technically bring more than three people into the broadcast. The others would just be in the lobby area waiting to be brought on cam. You also can add a logo and get rid of the BeLive watermark. So I think that's important, but they also introduce pricing. So I want you guys to see that. Right now, you can get a 14-day trial, but with the light version, which is $12 a month, you know, you can share photos, a custom logo, branded colors, and the talk show format broadcast per month. You only get 16 and basic support. But with the $20 a month program, which is the one that I would recommend because you also get the screen sharing capability and early access to new features. The branded frames I didn't think was such a big deal, so let's just take a look at them. I'm going to go live in one of my groups. Now, one of the advantages of BeLive is that you can go live in your groups that you are an admin of. Okay, so even if you're doing a test broadcast on this platform, you still have to give it a name. And you can schedule your broadcast if you want. Now, I'll show you the adding of the custom logo. I already had one in there, so I'll tell it to use that one. You have to use a 150 by 150 transparent PNG. Like I said, the frames are no big deal, so I'm not even going to bother showing you that. Text colors. I have already set my text color. This is the color that I like to use, but let's just show you what it would be like if I wanted to choose a different color. And I wanted my background to be white, but let's just show you if I chose the back background. That's not the greatest look ever, so let's just take it back to what I had it. So, you know, this just gives you a little bit of what I just told you here, but always read this in case right before you go live, especially the first time. Now, here is where you connect your camera. Before you even hit that connect camera button, hit the little cogwheel, and then set everything up. So for example, the default is 540, but hey, I want 720. Then for the microphone, I want my ATR 2100. Right, it's asking me for the webcam. Okay, I don't want to use a FaceTime camera, so now I'll say connect camera. All right, so now I'm still, notice, in the lobby section. If I want myself to now be on cam, even though I haven't started the broadcast yet. All right, so now I've taken myself out of the lobby section and put myself on cam. Okay, the sync is a little off because I'm doing two things. I'm recording this video and I'm actually using a platform. Normally, the sync is not off when you're actually live on Facebook. I like this feature where you're able to screen share, but let me get something up on my screen to screen share first. So I'm going to share my desktop screen. It's going to ask me which application do I want to share the entire window, which would be kind of silly and a little confusing. I'd rather share an application window. Just so happens that it's the Google Maps. And then I can add that to the broadcast. Now, you know, it's much better than still just using the regular Facebook Live without the screen sharing. So if I wanted to really zoom in on something on the map there and show it to you, hopefully I'd be able to show it to you. There's also the agenda feature. So let's just say this agenda was a BeLive tutorial, and then I could show that on the screen. And this description here would just be a note for myself if I wanted to say something about that. So then see how I could show that on screen. The other thing is, in order to invite your guests in, let's get rid of these agenda, and we're actually going to hide it, and we're going to get rid of it. Okay, this is the where you get the link that you send to your guests that you're going to have to come into the broadcast with you. As a matter of fact, let me get off the screen sharing. This is, oh, quick way to get take off the screen sharing or to just make a solo of anything. You just hit the solo button. So see now, even though the other item, the screen share, is still in the broadcast section with me, you're not seeing it because I hit the solo button. Let's try it with the screen share. So see, I slide over to the side. Okay. So of course I would have additional options for layout as more people come into the room. So if I had a third thing, oh, I could do it with a, let's do one of the albums. You have to sign into Facebook. And here's one that a presentation that I may show one day here. Okay, so now see how my views have increased. I take off the solo. Now it looks great when it's all three people on webcam and you know you're doing like a panel discussion or you're hanging out with your friends. Then it really looks great. With the screen sharing, it's not much point of screen sharing when it's so small people can't really see it. So I would just stick to just having the one thing up when I'm screen sharing. And then that way, you know, it makes sense. Okay, and like I said, this screen sharing is of an image that I have in a Facebook photo album. And you can have that album on your profile or on your page. If people were here, if I were live right now and people were leaving comments, I would see the comments right over here in this section. So I would be able to see those comments in real time. That's another huge benefit of BeliveTV. And so with that, guys, I hope that this overview was helpful for you in making a decision if you want to invest in the BeLive. Okay, so with that, guys, I want you to have a great time doing streaming no matter what platform you decide to use. So I'll see you guys soon. Thanks so much for everything, and I'll talk to you later. Bye for now.